Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We have another and final launch of 2020 to start this video and some other standard SpaceX updates. Then in Boca Chica we have a lot of action, particularly with Starship and Super Heavy prototypes, plus possible SN9 rollout soon. Let's head straight in and get up to date. First of all, on Thursday, SpaceX were expected to launch the NROL 108 mission but had to stand down. Musk tweeted, "Pressure is slightly high in upper stage liquid oxygen tank, review underway." Then yesterday, the Falcon 9 rocket lifted off with the NROL 108 satellite. Zero. Ignition. The booster, which was flying for the fifth time, then performed a picture-perfect landing on the pad at landing zone 1.
Engine relight. Here comes Falcon 9 for its fifth landing attempt.
Stay sure.
At landing zone 1.
Stage 1 landing light deploy.
Stage 2 start of terminal guidance.
And Falcon 9 does it again. That's 5 times for this booster and the 70th successful recovery of a Falcon 9 to date. Congratulations to all those that have been working on today's mission.
The booster, which launched the SXM-7 mission, returned to port and it wasn't quite standing right. It had quite a lean to it, as you can see with this great shot from Julia Bergeron. Last episode, we saw an article from Business Insider reporting that SpaceX was looking to double their valuation. In response to another article, Musk said this is incorrect. I thought I'd share part of another article from Engadget on how the year has been for SpaceX. It says 2020 has been very good to SpaceX, with the aerospace transportation firm surpassing a number of milestones and achieving virtually every goal it set out for itself during the year. Both the company's autonomous and crewed space vehicles operated without any major failures, as SpaceX earned its NASA flight certification along with deals with the US Space Force and private industry. There was one mishap with its prototype Starship vehicle during 2020, and even that only slightly set back SpaceX's march towards market dominance. So, with that standard information covered, in Boca Chica here you can see a great overview of the orbital launch pad construction. They were seen doing a bunch of work with the ground. Apparently they are burying conduit, which is stuff like electrical wiring. At the orbital launch pad area, there were also some new pieces spotted on the back of a trailer. Over at the tank farm, even more deliveries have been seen. We have a bunch more deliveries, and SpaceX are always needing rolls of steel with their vehicles, so some more were spotted arriving. These unknown pieces were also captured arriving. Also, inside the production area, what looked to be some prototype innards were spotted on a trailer. Nearby the production area as well were the roll lift transporters seen being moved to carry a mobile office building. In terms of Starships, the old Mark 1 nose cone, which was cut in half, is continuing to be dismantled. For future prototypes, some ring stacks were captured sitting out in the yard. We now have some tweets with information related to SN8's flight. Everyday Astronaut tweeted, "I assumed it would only use as little propellant as possible, but it seems like they really wanted to crawl up to apogee, so they loaded it." Musk responded with, "Far from fully loaded, but we were going slow or the ship would have gone crazy high or far with free engines." In response, Everyday Astronaut also tweeted, "Sorry, meant fully loaded as in pretty much as free Raptors could handle, since it lumbered off the pad and burned for over 4 minutes with shutdowns." Then Musk said the Raptors were well below max thrust or the ship would have blown through the altitude limit, as we hit minimum throttle point an engine would shut off. As we saw last episode, they've also been progressing with the cleanup of SN8 at the landing pad. The next testing candidate, which recently had a fall in the high bay, is SN9 and is back upright thanks to the giant crane. Engineers were seen working on the prototype to get it repaired after its little incident. Looking at the Cameron County website, some new road and beach closures have been posted. We have the first primary window tomorrow with back updates on Tuesday and Wednesday. Those are possibly for rollout. Then there's another primary closure on Monday 28th December with backups on the 29th and 30th. Those could possibly be for some testing, but that's just a guess. Further to SN9, the SN10 prototype is continuing to come together with this fin installed onto the nose cone. In preparation for its other canard and stacking, it was moved out of the windbreaker building. The nose cone barrel section, which has lead-ins, was then moved into the structure to wait for the nose to be stacked. The nose cone still doesn't have its second fin yet, but it's been hooked up to a crane for stacking. Then it was lifted and placed on top of the ring stack for the two to be welded together. Another Starship piece was seen with this aft domed skirt for SN15. We also have another new Starship serial number spotted with this first ring stack for SN17, which is super cool. This is the aft dome barrel section. As well as all that Starship stuff going on, SpaceX are working towards their first super heavy booster prototype. Whilst progress has been slow recently, this bulkhead, which has a label forward pipe dome, was seen on a sleeving mount. Its barrel section was then lifted and sleeved with the dome to form another piece of super heavy. Stainless steel rings with super heavy markings were also spotted out in the yard being moved into tents. I always like to show the latest diagram from Brendan Lewis as it gives a great overview of the progress. All of the Starships and the Super Heavy prototype are progressing incredibly well. As always, I can't finish the video without saying thanks to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Girl, who captures this awesome footage. Not only that, but behind the scenes is the NASA spaceflight team providing amazing space coverage, so thanks to them. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.